Well, I think there were a couple of strange things that we saw yesterday. Number one was the pronounced weakness in the cryptocurrencies, which showed you that it was more of a concern about liquidity. Since they are a currency, an asset that requires liquidity, pressure was put on them. I think today what we're seeing is a little bit the fact that it appears to be a rather localized threat. So far, it doesn't look like something that would become global, like the AIG problem or Lehman or whatever. That doesn't mean that it's not a problem. It does look like this property developer will have some difficulty paying people up. It does look like it may be localized. I would like to point out what I've been saying for weeks, and that is some of these shifts by President Xi, I think, are a kind of populist attempt. I suspect, without having anything in my hand to prove it, that he's beginning to sense there is a undercurrent of unrest in China. We don't have any political polls that are taken, and he doesn't need a vote of the populace as a whole. But prior governments in China over 3,000 years have fallen when there is public unrest. And I think he sees, you know, the wealth being concentrated here and there, and that's why he's trying to move out of it. And that was something that has exacerbated our problems. I would like to add, Carl, as I wrote in this morning's comment, we talk about seasonality. The autumnal equinox is a very particular point of volatility in the stock market. All the way back to legendary traders like W.D. Gann and others. In fact, Gann said September 22nd may be the most important date in any year. So we're right here. This is going to be a critical week. If we fail to hold the rebound, that will be a problem. If they roll into negative territory, traders and viewers should watch very carefully. You can't afford to make a lower low than yesterday. That'll be a problem.
Art, I'm so glad you brought up the seasonality piece of this. And I was reading your notes raptly, I have to say, especially where the autumnal equinox, which is scheduled for tomorrow, is concerned, and just the impact that has. Because if you look at the S&P, even with this little bit of a bounce today after what was a very rough day, very broadly yesterday, I mean, we're still on pace for the worst month for the S&P since last September. I mean, are there technical or fundamental reasons you tend to see this type of weakness at this type of year? Or is it just a historical pain point that either way needs to be acknowledged by traders and investors?
Well, Morgan, I'll tell you, I've been studying it for over 60 years in this business. Early on, up until 1939, 1940-something, you could explain it because we were still very much an agrarian society. So money would shift from city banks to country banks when people, the farmers had to pay for seeds and planting and fertilizer and things like that. And then the money would reverse and shift the other way when the factories had to pay for the crops, to get the wheat, to make the cookies, to make the whatever. And all of that made a great deal of sense because it was money shifts between city banks and country banks, and that brought strains. And that made September, October, and May and June critical periods for the market. But long ago, we wound up with more smokestacks than haystacks, and yet it's there. So I don't know if it's what doctors call the phantom pain. You know, if you've had a, God forbid, an arm amputated, sometimes it feels like the missing wrist is itchy. So it's recurring. It's there. I'd love to be able to give you a much better explanation, Morgan, but I see it happen year after year. And I will tell you next year as we get to the autumnal equinox, I will tell you to fasten your seatbelt.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.